What's up, crypto fam? Welcome back to the Crypto Breakdown Kadena Whiteboard mini-series. In this mini-series, I'm going to help you understand every aspect about the Kadena blockchain from a first principle standpoint. Ready? Let's dive deep. Bitcoin and Kadena are fueled by technology called the blockchain. When we talk about blockchain technology from a first principle standpoint, Kadena is by far the most advanced blockchain technology in the world. Kadena is the hardest asset that scales vertically. And shout out to anybody listening that actually understands what that means. So in today's video, I'm going to help you understand what a blockchain is from a first principle standpoint. Let's start with blockchain technology. To help you get a better understanding of why blockchain technology is so powerful, I'm going to teach you guys using an analogy that was created by Anthony Pompliano. Question number one, why was blockchain technology created in the first place? Blockchain technology was created to prevent what is called the double spend problem. Now, in order to understand the solution, you first have to understand the problem. So let's say I create music. Let's say that I release my first single and I put it out as an MP3 file. Now, my best friend Jason, he loves music, so the first thing I do is I send him a copy. Jason listens to the song and he's like, dang, Matta, that's a banger. That track is straight fire. So Jason tweets about it, and a few hours later, Jason's buddy Drake hits him up and he's like, yo, dog, let me get a copy of Matta's new track. So Jason goes over to his email, he uploads the track, and he hits the send button. Now, what Jason's computer just did is it made a copy of the original song. It uploads it to the cloud server, and then it sends a copy to the recipient. So now Drake has a copy of that song, and there's essentially two copies of the original, right? Jason has a copy, Drake has a copy, and I still have the original copy. And in reality, now everybody can jam out to this track, so everybody's happy. But neither Jason or Drake can tell if they have the original copy. All they can tell is that they got a file. And that's fine when it comes to music. I mean, that's fine when it comes to photos or videos. I mean, it's fine for a lot of different things. But what it's not fine for is anything that involves scarcity. And what it's definitely not okay for is for money. Now let's talk about a digital dollar. So if I ask you to send me a dollar, or you ask me to send you a dollar, I could, or we could in theory, both have these digital dollars in our crypto wallet. How would we know what dollar is the real dollar, or if they're real at all? How would I know that you didn't just counterfeit that dollar that you just sent to me? So over the last several years, there have been a lot of different people that have tried to create digital currencies, and this is the big problem. When you're talking about a digital item, the file can be replicated easily. And it's very hard to prove what is the original. And that is what's called the double spend problem. I could easily make a copy of my digital dollar. I could send a dollar to Jason. I could send a dollar to Drake, and they would both think they just got paid. But what if I just sent them both a counterfeit copy of my dollar? You see, this is the problem that proof of work blockchains like Kadena and Bitcoin solve. They also both have finite supplies, meaning that no government or organization can ever change that. I'm sure you've heard the saying, cash is trash. Well, that comes from the fact that you can't save in dollars, period. Governments print more money than they make. US dollars are not backed by any physical asset. And every time the government raises the debt limit or prints more money, the value of the dollar depreciates and everything around you goes up in value. Essentially, inflation is legalized counterfeiting and all governments are addicted to it. So the key to this is understanding counterfeit versus original. For example, let's say we all go play Monopoly. And this is by far the best way to explain this, so please stick with me. So there's four of us and we all sit down to play Monopoly. In the game of Monopoly, you have the bank, and what's nice about the bank is the money is sitting right in front of you on the table. Everyone can see it. This is what makes the game of Monopoly so fun. It's transparent. If Jason passes go and gets to collect $200, everyone sitting around the table at the board gets to watch Jason pay himself the $200, or the designated banker pays Jason. But either way, everyone sitting at the game gets to witness that transaction, right? I mean, if there was four of us playing a game of Monopoly, we don't need a fifth person to stand over us and act like the banker or a centralized third party who deals with all the transactions. And why is that? Because there is full transparency, right? I mean, how many times have you played Monopoly with your little kid, your little brother or sister, and they try to put money under the table or on their lap. And you're like, nah, 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 nah. Get that crap back up here right now. We ain't playing the game like that. I don't know what you're trying to do under that table over there, but I don't trust you. Drop a like and hit that subscribe button if you know what I'm talking about. So when the money is put out on the table and all transactions happen in front of everybody, we don't need to trust anyone. We can verify it ourselves. I mean, just think about how much more you would trust the government if you could see where every dollar was that they spent. Now, let me explain how this can relate to a blockchain. So let's say we're playing that same game of Monopoly, and every time anybody spends any money, whether that's paying to get out of jail, buying property, paying somebody taxes because you landed on their railroad, or getting to collect $200 because you passed go, what if I recorded every single transaction and wrote that on a sheet of paper? So at the start of the game, I start with a full audit of the game. I count and record every single penny in the bank, $20,000. Then I pass out money from the bank and I give each player $2,000. Player 1, 2, 3, and 4. Now, I'm also going to record the date and time of every transaction as it takes place. Anytime a player spends money or wins money, that transaction gets recorded on the list. So the game goes on and I'm constantly adding new transactions to the list, almost just like a ledger. But let's say every 10 minutes, I take that original list, I fold it up into a small square, I label it as list 1, and I put it off to the side of the table. That list represents the first 10 minutes of the game, and on that paper is a list of every transaction that took place in the first 10 minutes. Then we play the game for another 10 minutes and I do the same thing. I record every transaction. After that 10 minutes goes by, I rip off that sheet of paper, I fold it up into a square, and I label it list 2. And bam, I stack it right on top of list 1. Now let's say we've been playing the game for about 50 minutes, and we have a total of 5 stacks of paper off on the side of the table, and Jason looks at his bank account and thinks that he's missing money. He thinks that when Drake landed on Boardwalk, he forgot to pay him. Well, since we recorded every transaction, we would be able to go back to that list of transactions and instantly determine how much each player should have in their Monopoly bank. If Jason's bank account was short money and Drake's bank account was over the exact amount that Jason's bank account was short, it would be very easy to verify which player was correct. So that is literally exactly what a blockchain does. But instead of recording it on paper, it records it on the blockchain. The blockchain is just one big network of connected computers, aka miners. Anytime anybody wants to interact with Bitcoin, they must use the Bitcoin network. So anytime a transaction takes place, the miners are just moving Bitcoin from one wallet address to the next. The Bitcoin miners process the transactions that they verify, and they verify that the person sending the Bitcoin is the owner of that Bitcoin wallet by verifying their private keys. And then they send that Bitcoin from your wallet to whatever wallet address you choose. That transaction is then placed into the next block, and after 10 minutes, that block gets closed. The miners re-verify every transaction, then that block is mined and put onto the blockchain. The blocks are all linked together using what is called a cryptographic hash. How blockchains are linked together is super cool, but it's going to take me another 5 to 10 minutes to explain it, so we'll save that for the next video. Now, what makes Kadena so much more advanced than Bitcoin is the fact that when Kadena originally launched, their blockchain launched with 10 blockchains, just like Bitcoin, and then they scaled up to 20 blockchains using a technique called hash braiding. I'm sure you've heard a lot of people complaining about how much energy Bitcoin uses. Well, guess what? Kadena also has the ability to scale up to 10,000 blockchains and process 480,000 transactions while at the same time consuming less energy than one Bitcoin blockchain or one Ethereum blockchain. I mean, that's some real next level technology right there, boys and girls. Well, that's a wrap, crypto fam, but check this out. If you're interested in learning more about Kadena, or why I say that the Kadena blockchain is going to change every aspect of life as we know it, check out my playlist linked down in the description, and then come join us live on my second YouTube channel, and I'll answer any questions you got. Good vibes always, crypto fam.